We Are You Morning Crew, ladies and gentlemen. The lady here to my left, she is Jana Maymay Aloysius Jr. Jenkins, the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, Dr. MD, DDS, Esquire, ROLAIDS, Fleming. And yes, that's all on her nameplate. And okay. Over here to my right is the gentleman known as Nova C of the Lawtooths. And this gentleman here in the middle is Nate Nasty Nasty Couser. Better known to the lady as just plain Nasty Nate. Yes, we are here.
He's a savage.
And Savage, you got a tattoo of Savage on his left arm. Just so you know who it is. Yeah. So we are here, ladies and gentlemen, fully assembled, ready to answer your questions. This motley crew has another one, and Nova's about to read it.
But before Nova reads it.
Yes.
I have something to say.
Listening.
You know, I was told not to talk about COVID.
Okay, time's up.
I just want to say one thing.
Okay, what's
every
up?
State reporting, we're back up to 100,000 new cases. That's all. Go ahead. Carry
that's
on.
That's what I... That makes me mad. That just made me
mad. COVID's still a thing, y'all. You know what else is still a thing?
Yes. What is it still a thing?
My girlfriend called me gay.
Why would she do that?
Let's find out together. The letter reads...
Oh, it's a letter. I was like, wait a minute, Nova.
My... I told my 32. Wait, come on, y'all.
Not us.
I know English is a hard language, but damn.
Oh my gosh.
Let me give me a second. I gotta read this a couple times so I can make. It's only two. This letter is literally three sentences, and I gotta read it four times.
Well, when you first said that,
okay, we're gonna skip this. I told my girlfriend that I was interested in having her put a toy in my butt, and she told me I was gay for that, even though I have zero attraction to men. I'm a 32-year-old male. She's a 29-year-old female. Just looking for thoughts or advice on how to handle this. We Are You Morning Crew. What up with that?
Jana.
So wait a minute, say that again.
I'm not a man. Y'all need to answer that one.
Yeah, but I told my girlfriend that I was, I'll just read the whole thing again. It's only two sentences.
Yeah.
I told my girlfriend that I was interested in having her put a toy in my butt, and she told me I was gay, that I was gay for that, even though I have zero attraction to men. Just looking for thoughts or advice on the matter. What's up with that?
Jana, I mean, if a man came to you and said that, what would your thoughts be? Because that's where I want to start. What would your thoughts be?
Well, I don't know. I mean, if he says he's not attracted to men, okay, he says he's not attracted to men and put something up his butt.
I mean, like, here you go.
I mean, that seems to be the obvious answer, but for some reason, I just don't feel like that's how it's going to really go.
You know, here's the thing, and I saw a video, it was some months back, and these two women were sitting there talking about, you know, sex and their experiences. And one girl said, if I was dating a guy and he let me play with his butt, I would immediately break up with him because clearly he wants some dick up there. Ladies, for those of you that don't, that's what she said. That's what she said. That he got to be gay. That's what and that was the end of it, the thick of it. And I was like, okay, first of all, for some of you ladies who are listening, you know, you allies who are, you know, heterosexuals, men have a prostate. And unlike women, you can feel pleasure, be stimulated. You can actually have a greater erection if your prostate is stimulated. It's just a fact. It doesn't mean that a man wants to have sex with another man. It just means that he's aware of the stimulation and the pleasure he can receive by having his prostate stimulated. Now, ma'am or sir, in your case with this girl, who has such a narrow mindset of what sexuality actually is, because I really believe sexuality is fluid. Whether you identify as gay or heterosexual, it's really fluid, because it, you know, it extends, it ebbs and flows. She has the issue. Don't take that on. You know what you are. You know who you are. You know what you're attracted to. You can try and explain it, but because of her narrow view, her narrow experience, her non-understanding of human sexuality, she's going to assume what she's learned.
Maybe she can be tough. Maybe she doesn't know anything about the prostate. Everybody doesn't know what you know.
If the first thing you say, though, if the first thing you say, though, is you gay, even if he gave her a great explanation and showed her a visual and a picture, that's her first thought. She's going to stick with that. It's going to be
necessarily.
You're right. You might. You're right. I will give her the benefit of the doubt.
Well, see, because here's the thing. If that's the environment that you've been brought up in, where we know a lot of us have been, right? Then I understand why that would be her understanding.
Immediate response, right?
I mean, maybe she does need some education. Maybe you should tell her about the prostate being in the anus. And so, you know, toys are just ways to have extra stimulation, mm-hmm. right? I mean, girls do it all the time. Let's not act like pegging doesn't exist, right? Like it's a thing, mm-hmm. but it just seems like a rather closed view, I guess, on using toys
in certain communities,
right?
In
certain now, if he said, "Let's invite another man into the bedroom," so you know he could do it, then you may want to question, you know, that there may be some other decisions being made there,
right?
But it's just like wearing a collar in BDSM doesn't mean that you want to be a dog, or an animal of some sort. It's just, you know, it's just another way to stimulate a pleasure response.
Right.
And I think
I'd like to go
The hetero, I would just like to put out there for the other heteros that, it's 2021. I would like us to maybe think about, I don't know that, well, in my world anyway, gay doesn't really exist as an insult anymore. I think we need to kind of get away from that. Like it just seems so out. It seems like an outdated thing at this point. That seems archaic at this point, but mm-hmm. you know, do you, I guess.
But you know what? I want to circle back to this collar that you were talking about earlier. This mm-hmm. this animal thing. Can we talk about that a little bit? It sounds like
sure. Yes, yes. I am not against toy play. I've never tried the anal stuff, but I'm not against it. But I mean, I think people just conflate the meaning of things. Like, just because you like something doesn't mean that you, why does it always have to be extremes, I guess, is my question. It's either you have to be this way or that way, and that's it. Those are the only two choices. Mm-hmm. There's no in between. You either have vanilla or you're a freak.
Right.
There's no mixing and matching, or sometimes I like it vanilla, sometimes I like it freaky, sometimes, you know, maybe I want to tie her to the bed, sometimes maybe she want to tie me to the bed. Sometimes we just don't want to do neither. We just want to do missionary and be done with it. Like, why can't I have all of those options and choices? Mm-hmm.
There's
and I don't
a lot
like
of-
to be limited by other people's, don't let nobody else gets to define you.
Right.
That's another thing. Don't let them define you.
There's a lot of ignorance in general, specifically from women about things that men do. And I've heard things like, if a man puts chapstick on directly from the tube, that makes him a little suspect. If he takes
shit. Am I gay?
I never heard of that one.
Am I gay? Because I do.
I've heard that one too.
I mean, just a lot of things that are ignorance. But if you get your information about the world from your peers, I'm worried. And that's one thing my mother used to tell me. Like, she would tell me something first so I would not get false or skewed information from one of my friends who's just as ignorant as I was. But I think the same thing is happening even as adults. A lot of this information is being circulated. And it's the idea of if you catch a man sitting down on a toilet, he's suspect. Mm-hmm. And I always would say, well, what if he has to do number two?
Oh, Jesus.
Like, how does he go to the bathroom?
I'm not going to be able to do this show anymore.
I'm almost sure who those people
the
are.
The longer I talk, the more I think I'm gay.
But he is saying a lot of those mythos that I heard as a kid, too. I promise you, it's there. But here's where it is. Nate, Nova, you said it, and I said it earlier. You just said it a different way. Sexuality is a fluid thing. It goes through ebbs and flows. If you are not necessarily this or that, you can be somewhere in between and not either of the two. If your partner wants to be pleased and they're not asking you to go beyond, you know, you know, just cut yourself or hang yourself on a rope for asphyxiation. Some people do that for pleasure, by the way. You know, if it's something within your means,
we don't recommend it. Don't try that.
Yeah, please don't try that. We already saw how that ended with the actor guy. But nonetheless, back to the problem. Just, you know, explore. Is it something that's out of your comfort zone? If it's something that makes you feel uncomfortable, does it make you feel differently about your partner? Then that's, I always say, that's your stuff. That's not his. That's your stuff. So you deal with that and move on. But sir, don't feel bad. You want your booty played with? I know some people that play with your booty, sir. I'm just saying. I know some people.
And that's how it started.
But wait. So if it's another woman that wants to play with his butt.
Yeah, I know
some. And he accepts that.
Yeah.
That wouldn't be gay. But if another man, if you wanted another man to play with a toy in his butt, would that be gay?
A part of me feels like that's how it probably starts with some people, because I have this curiosity and this person who I trusted is totally against it. I'm gonna find somebody who is comfortable with it, and sometimes I think that may be another guy. I don't. That's just my opinion. You don't have to write that in the law book.
I'm just saying, I don't. The more we have this conversation, the more I'm wondering, where is the borderline between, like, when do you cross over into gay?
Here's the thing. If you're having sex with the same sex, you're gay. That's how it goes. But just because you want to do things that are considered out of the norm of heterosexuality does not mean you're gay. If you want a woman to stimulate your prostate, you've never had the desire to have a man do it. You want your wife to do it. Maybe you want to be dominated by a woman. I don't know. But whatever the case may be, that doesn't make you gay. Having sex.
But see, even the way you started off this last statement, it's still, I feel like it's still not fair to some people who do want to try things. Because if a woman is allowed to do it and then she can go back to her straight life, I've never seen a line of demarcation. I think everybody is on a spectrum, and no matter where you fall on that spectrum is where you fall. And I don't think it's one clear-cut answer to it. Unless that person has that feeling, then we can say, then yes. If I hear it from them, then I'm going to say, okay, you're gay. But until I hear it from you, I can't speculate.
Well, let's stick to this.
Or measure you.
Well, let's stick to this letter, because this gentleman has said that he is not gay. He doesn't have the desire to have sex with a man. He has said this. So
zero attraction to men.
Yeah, so I want to stay. I want to stay there, because you're right on the spectrum. But in this particular instance, this particular man says, "I don't want to have sex with a man. I just like my butt played with." He didn't say that. My words. But if he wants his girl to play with his butt, if she doesn't, there's gonna be another chick that will. That's all I'm saying. Now, that is what Nate said. That's what.
Well, that's facts.
Yeah.
That's facts on air. That's facts on everything.
Right.
Like sex or anything else. If somebody don't want to do it, trust and believe, there's somebody on this earth that will.
Right.
Regardless of what it is you think, however perverted you think you are, there's a kinky out there than you.
Right.
Somewhere.
Yes.
Yeah. I have a site that you can go to if you're looking to do that.
Whoa, Bucko, wait a minute.
Oh, my God.
We're not going to put that out here on the air. We're going to put that on our Instagram. So if y'all want to know the site that Nate uses to find his partners, make sure you go to Instagram, search at WERUradio, WERUradio, all one word. And we're going to give you the hookup. You want whips, chains, pain, collars, BDSM, butt plugs, pegging.
You sure know those?
The food stuff.
You're sure rattling
those
off.
You like your toes get sucked on. You like it, huh?
You sure are rattling all of those off. Like, just
I'm just going through all the stuff that I like to do, but that's neither here nor there. We talking about Nate and his site. So y'all go to Instagram. And we gonna hook y'all up over there. Don't give it out. Don't give it out for free, Nate. Let's make some a little bit of change off this one.
It is the We Are You Morning Crew, ladies.
Put it in
and
the
gentlemen.
Chat though, because I'm interested.
My God. We are trying to help you while we help ourselves, and some of us need a little bit more help than others. It is the We Are You Morning Crew. We'll be back. Good morning.
Good morning. The We Are You Morning Crew.